Hi, it's March 17th, 2016. We're in Johannesburg at the Holiday Inn. We just came out of a meeting of the high-level panel on access to medicine. I'm here with Babalwa. Babalwa, can you tell us a little bit about yourself first?
I'm Babalwa. I'm 41 years old. I'm a breast cancer survivor. I'm from South Africa, from a province called Eastern Cape, in a small township called Danzani. I was diagnosed with breast cancer in 2011, and I started my chemotherapy in 2012. After finishing my chemotherapy, it was discovered that I have HER2 positive. As a result, I needed Herceptin. But unfortunately, my medical aid in a private sector denied paying for my Herceptin. So I had to check the public hospitals. When I went to the public hospital, I discovered that South Africa does not have Herceptin at all. In South Africa, it's only one hospital that has Herceptin, and that is Kimberley. Kimberley is very, very far from where I'm living. And as a result, Kimberley's budget could not have afforded me Herceptin because it was only meant for their patients. Whereas in my province, there's an influx of people coming from other provinces, and that results in unequal access to healthcare. I had to fight with my medical aid, use every resource that I have for me to be able to use Herceptin. As a result, until today, I'm not sure if I was actually given Herceptin or an alternative. Because at the same time, being a cancer patient, I was depressed and I wasn't giving it all my all. So what I know is that after fighting with my medical aid and with the help of my oncologist, I was called and I was given an injection that I used I was using every 3 months. Every 3 months I had to have that injection under my skin. I'm currently on tamoxifen. And the sad part is even the issue of Herceptin, if your oncologist does not tell you about it, you end up not knowing whether you were supposed to be given it or not. For today, the request that we had from this high-level panel was that they consider the issue of intellectual property laws. They try and reform them. In South Africa specifically, our request is that they be thoroughly examined. The applications to register the patent rights must be thoroughly examined. We also request that they should set a high bar and not just allow anything that is called a patent. We also request that we be allowed to propose before registration as well as after registration. And my final request is that the issue of global license will be more seriously considered.
Do you have children? Do you have children?
My children? Yes, I do. I have two cute boys, a 10-year-old as well as a 5-year-old, but they were 5 and 1 when I was diagnosed.
And when were you diagnosed? What year?
2011.
Okay. So this is the fifth year.
Yes, this is my birthday.
Thank you very much.